What's up, gamers? Cryptico here, and welcome to the 8th episode of Lowering the Mark, a show where I analyze the world records of Mario Kart 8 Deluxe Time Trial runs to see how these runs get faster over time. We'll look at elements such as the loadout, racing lines, and mushroom usage to get a better understanding of how these records evolve. If you haven't already, please consider subscribing to my channel and hitting the notification bell to be the first to know when my videos go live. For today's episode, we're going to revisit the 200cc category and look at another user-suggested course, N64 Rainbow Road. On April 27th, 2017, the world record for this run was just under a minute at 59.721 seconds, and it was held by the player Chun. Fast forward to March 27th, 2020, and the record now sits at 56.691 seconds thanks to the player Tane. That's a 3-second improvement and a 5.1% faster time. This was one of the first two records that broke the 1-minute barrier, which was already a flex, but players didn't stop there. Everyone began posting times, hoping to be the one to grab the next second break. Let's see how Tane did it. The one thing you'll see in both loadouts today is speed. Both players utilize a heavy character and a fast car to maximize their top speed, which is good for a course like this at 200cc because it's mostly straightaways and wide turns. Chun uses the combo of Bowser with the Circuit Special Kart, Slim Tires, and the MKTV Parafoil. Tane uses Dry Bowser with the Mach 8 Kart, Leaf Tires, and the Cloud Glider. Don't be fooled by both players picking a heavy character because their base stats are not identical in this instance. While the speed, acceleration, and mini turbo stats are equal, Tane has the early advantage on handling and grip stats. The Circuit Special drops Chun's acceleration and mini turbo stats significantly. It only adds more to the weight and top speed, which is still a good thing, but not the best option. Tane did his homework and picked the Mach 8 because it minimizes the damage done to the loadout. Handling acceleration don't take as big of a hit with this kart. Chun was more focused on building a Formula 1 car than a viable Mario Kart loadout when he picked the Slim Tires. They only decrease acceleration, grip, and mini turbo stats further below their optimum levels. Tane is already working with a lot of top speed, so he decides to pick wheels that increase his areas that are lacking. The Leaf wheels are the perfect complement to this loadout as they provide a nice boost in acceleration and mini turbo to go with his top speed. Now both players pick a glider that will increase their acceleration and mini turbo stats further, but Tane grabs an additional boost in handling to go with his lighter overall loadout. Like I said earlier, we got high speed and low handling from both racers, but Tane has that extra boost in mini turbo that will allow him to bring this record down. Let's check out the run. Since this is a sprint course and it's a 200cc run, having many sections doesn't make a lot of sense, so I'm just going to analyze the course by lap instead. Chun will use a rocket start to get a great boost out of the starting line as he heads for the 4 speed mats and fly ramp to take him through the 2 speed rings right before he hits the anti-gravity portion of the lap. He drifts impossibly tight, enough to where the entire front of his kart is off the course entirely. After he grabs a super mini turbo from that turn, he heads into the wavy portion of the lap and grabs a few jump boosts there before closing out the first lap. Tane uses a mushroom out of the gate to get ahead and grab the speed mats and fly right into the speed rings before drifting on that same impossible line that Chun took. Tane also grabs only a super mini turbo, but as he navigates through the wavy portion of lap 1, he'll grab one additional jump boost before closing out the first lap. Not much difference between the two than this first lap, but the longer lasting mini turbo and extra jump boost put Tane ahead of Chun by exactly 1 second after lap 1. Chun uses his first mushroom right as he heads into the loop and grabs an ultra mini turbo. He grabs one jump boost in the second wavy portion of the course before using his second mushroom to zoom down the straightaway before the final turn of lap 2. He ends up grabbing one of each mini turbo and one jump boost this lap. Tane tackles the loop on lap 2 the same way that Chun does, except he does not use a mushroom. After grabbing an ultra mini turbo, he rides down the wavy portion with the same jump boost but also sneaks in another mini turbo before using a mushroom to get back up to speed. You might also have noticed that Tane flew off the course for a brief moment to cut part of it out, a risky maneuver but incredibly rewarding. After lap 2, Tane leads the former world record by over 1.5 seconds thanks to quicker lines and more boosts. For lap 3, Chun sticks to the script and takes a pretty good line with great turns. He drifts a bit wide in order to take the turns tight without having to brake drift. He'll grab a few mini turbos before using his last mushroom to keep his speed up and take the last few turns before hitting the fly ramp to soar all the way to the finish line. Tane really separates himself from Chun on this lap. He takes the lap 3 turns very tight as he keeps his speed up thanks to using his last mushroom in the same spot that Chun did. He's almost off the course again on the turns before the final fly ramp. He grabs one more jump boost off the fly ramp and just coasts on in to the start of the course to finish the race a whole 3 seconds faster than the former world record. Tane was able to accomplish this world record by taking impossibly tight turns and grabbing more boosts throughout the course. His better loadout is also attributable to his victory. N64 Rainbow Road at 200cc has seen many second breaks over the years, and Tane has taken the baton as the player to keep bringing the record down. It's been quiet this past month, but there are still a few tenths of a second that can be shaved off by anybody, to which Tane will surely respond. Another month has gone by, which means it's time for an update on some of the current world records of courses I've covered in the past. Three of these courses saw a faster time since I covered them last. The record for TikTok clock at 150cc got a few hundredths faster just this week thanks to the player Akashi. The record currently stands at 1 minute 43.927 seconds as of May 20th, 2020. The world record for Twisted Mansion at 150cc also got faster. The player known only as THS knocked Axel and his 166-day-old record into the second place spot by posting a time that was 1/1000th of a second faster. THS went 155.396 to capture the world's fastest time. As many of you know from watching episode 6, the world record for Mount Wario got a few hundredths of a second faster right after I had finished an episode on Aline's record thanks to the player Kirorin. That time now sits at 1 minute 42.716 seconds as of May 8th, 2020. That's the end of episode 8. If you are enjoying this series, please hit that like button and let me know in the comments which course you want me to analyze next. Don't forget to subscribe, and I'll see you guys in the next one.